You're listening to the Love Over Addiction podcast. Last week, we talked specifically to parents who have children struggling with this disease. The key takeaway was that their addiction is not your fault. And I encouraged you to stop taking the blame that doesn't belong to you. So if you're new to our podcast or community, I encourage you to listen to that episode. Today, I want to talk about the main reasons our loved ones become addicted. Why does this help you? Because if we understand the why, it will help us remove the unnecessary blame from ourselves. And like everything in our community at loveoveraddiction.com, we keep things simple, short, and sweet with lots of loving truths. Because I cover so many tools in our programs, I like to keep them really simple so you remember them. Otherwise, it can feel overwhelming. According to a study published in the American Journal on Addictions, one of the reasons addiction happens to people is because of a traumatic and stressful event occurred in their lives. Perhaps they experienced the death of a loved one, or they grew up with another family member who is suffering from addiction. Maybe they were sexually assaulted, experienced a severe accident, or turned down for a dream job. Perhaps your son or daughter showed extreme courage and served in our military. A lot of soldiers come home with post-traumatic stress disorder and turn to drugs and alcohol to cope. Not having coping skills to deal with trauma can lead to addictive behaviors. The second possible reason your child became addicted is due to genetic predisposition. They might also be suffering from attention deficit or hyperactivity disorder, depression, bipolar disorder, or addiction might be a part of their family history. Do any of their aunts or uncles, siblings, parents, or grandparents suffer from addiction? Or perhaps you have struggled with addiction. If your child has grown up in a home with addiction, it is easy to blame yourself for not leaving or providing them with an addiction-free home. But let's be clear. Your child is a human being, and all human beings are given free will. In other words, no one held up a bottle to their mouths or made them swallow the pills or snort the line of cocaine. No one gave them the needle. They choose to ingest the substances on their own. Sure, they might have grown up watching their parents struggle with this disease, but ultimately, it's always been their choice. There are plenty of children who come from devastating homes that choose never to touch a drop of alcohol and refuse to be around drugs. So please resist the urge to blame yourself if you or anyone else they grew up around struggled with addiction. Something important for you to know. There is no judgment in this community. We have so much in common, and we can all relate to how you're feeling. We understand how normal it is to love your child, but also feel angry at the same time. It's common to blame yourself some days, but at the same time, feel completely hopeless. You have found your people, your community. We are from different parts of the world, different races, religions, and income levels. But what I am trying to say is that you are safe here. And because we put a super high priority on safety, I'm going to ask you to be honest with me and with yourself at all times. If you are in denial, now is the time to join us in reality. And the deeper you're willing to go with your honesty, the deeper your healing. So now that we've covered in very broad and simple terms why your child is struggling with addiction, we also need to acknowledge that we are not and never want to be the experts who will help your child get sober. I don't partner with rehabs, even though we get a tremendous amount of requests, and I have never endorsed a book written on ways to get help with anyone sober. That is very, very intentional. My research and time and passion is discovering ways to help you truly get to a place where you are happy and healthy and making wise and thoughtful decisions that honor your best life. Because here's the honest and hard truth. Your child is a grown-up. They are an adult. And if they wanted to get sober, they would. They have a choice every single day to learn proper coping skills. Or maybe they already know what they need to do to get sober, probably thanks to all your efforts to help them. But they just don't want to get sober enough right now. Whatever the reason, their sobriety is not happening because of something you did or didn't do. There is no need to blame yourself or your partner. If they are old enough to drink or do drugs, they are old enough to get sober. Thousands of people make the choice to get sober every day. Your child can make better choices if they want to. Their addiction is not your problem to solve. But does this mean you're powerless? Do you need to just sit back and watch them ruin their lives and hope that they get better? Absolutely not. There are very specific things that you can do that will empower yourself and as a result might help them quit their bad choices. Or maybe it won't help them get sober, but it will help you become unstuck, let go of pain, and transition into happiness and peace. And one of the ways the Love Over Addiction community is different is that we don't believe you are powerless over this disease. The common philosophy in the world of addiction is to admit that we are powerless over this disease, and that is simply not one we subscribe to. Surrendering isn't a word we use often because it makes us feel powerless. We feel like surrendering means giving up. Surrendering makes us feel helpless. So don't surrender. Don't give up. Don't let go of your child. Instead, I'm going to help you learn inside our new program, Love Over Addiction for Parents, what you can do, and then we'll work on it together. Now, if you enjoyed what I just read, I've taken it directly from the very, very first few parts of the program. There is tons of tools. And if you want to join us, we have a special secret Facebook group. And if not, if you're not ready, that's okay too. We will always, always be here for you and you can enjoy the podcast. It's completely free. Either way, I am here for you. I am your greatest fan and I want to be the loudest voice right now reminding you that you can do this and that there is a finish line in place. I'll talk to you later.
If you're a parent and you're ready to learn more about our brand new program, Love Over Addiction for Parents, head over to loveoveraddiction.com/parents. If you're a wife or a partner, you can check out our Love Over Addiction program at loveoveraddiction.com/LOA. And if you have questions you'd like Michelle to answer or topics you'd like her to cover in this free podcast, please let us know. Our email address is info@loveoveraddiction.com. And lastly, remember to subscribe wherever you listen so you'll never miss an episode. Thanks so much for listening, and we'll see you next week. This podcast is created for your support, encouragement, and entertainment with Michelle's personal thoughts and beliefs. From one woman to another, bonded together by the fact we love someone suffering from addiction. This is not intended as a substitute for therapy or advice from a professional.